Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to another MCC Development Update 343. Every month puts out a bit of a blog to keep the community up to date with how the development of the Master Chief Collection is going. And yesterday's development update is extremely juicy. There is a lot of very, very exciting information within it. I like to make these videos so that you guys don't have to bother reading through the entire blog. I kind of make it very digestible in this video so you all get the best bits in a short video form. So hopefully you appreciate that. I recently noticed that 69% of people that watch my videos aren't even subscribed. Yes, literally 69% of people. So if you fall into that category, make sure you hit that sub button. I'm trying to hit 80,000 subscribers before the end of the summer. If we can do that, that will be absolutely amazing. But without further ado, let's get into the latest update from the Halo Master Chief Collection. The blog starts off talking about the Halo 3 flighting, which has now come to an end. They let us know that over 350,000 people were invited to the flight, which is insane to think about that many people bothered to sign up just to have a chance of testing Halo MCC early. That is incredible. They were able to knock out nearly 100 different bugs due to everyone's help. So shout out to all the Halo Insiders for doing a fantastic job. They give us a little bit of an update on Halo 3 Firefight, which if you didn't know, Firefight for ODST is indeed coming whenever ODST releases. It's not going to cost any more money if you already own ODST on Xbox. So the fact that ODST Firefight is making its way to the MCC on Xbox and PC is really, really exciting. So then they go into a big engineering discussion about the audio and how the audio rework has been going for the MCC. If you didn't know, the MCC's audio was a little bit strange compared to the legacy games. It was not one-to-one with how the original game sounded. Of course, the community were not too happy about this. We wanted our OG sounds of Halo back, so 343 have been working extremely hard to bring back the original sounds, and in the Halo 3 flight, they were working perfectly. The BR was sounding crisp as ever. It sounded beautiful, but they basically go into a deep dive, letting us know how all this audio rework is going. I'll be honest with you, it goes completely over my head. This is way more technical stuff than I would ever know when it comes to audio, but I'm sure some of you watching this video would be very, very interested in reading more about this. So a link to the entire update will be in the description, as always, for you to check out yourself. I'm not going to go through all of this, but if you want to check out the audio work for the MCC, this is a very, very interesting read. So after the audio discussion, they go on to something that I think is extremely, extremely exciting. There is a brand new skull coming to the Halo 3 campaign. Skulls are one of my favorite things in all of Halo, so the fact they're adding a brand new one to Halo 3, a 13-year-old game, is absolutely incredible. It's awesome that they're bothering to do that. Thankfully, they also add a little video for the Acrophobia skull, which is the new skull coming to Halo 3, to let us know what it's like. The way that they describe it is basically like a jetpack. You jump once and then you hold the jump button again and you start flying around as if you had a jetpack on. So this is going to be very, very interesting. It's going to let people explore Halo 3 in ways that we never have before. So I cannot wait to see what people are able to do with this skull and maybe new things that people are going to be able to find with it as well. So I'm definitely going to be making a video showing off the new skull whenever Halo 3 is released. But it also gives me hope for the future of the older Halo games. Maybe they'll bother adding new skulls to some of the other games or more to Halo 3. So if any of you have any cool skull ideas, leave them down in the comments. Let me know some cool skull ideas that you would like to see in Halo, and you never know, 343 might just add them. So after the skull discussion, they go on to talk about something that I never saw happening for the MCC. I thought this was just an impossibility. I just didn't think this would actually be like possible because of how the engines are, but 343 have absolutely knocked it out of the park. They have decided to add something to the game that I think people are going to be very, very excited about. So as you can see from this image, it's a Warthog in Combat Evolved, but it's not just any old Warthog. It's a bit of an updated one. It looks a little bit meaner than what we're used to. So in Season 2 of the MCC, which is now confirmed to be coming with Halo 3, we're not only going to be getting nameplates and stuff like that, but they're also going to be bringing Combat Evolved weapon and vehicle skins to the game. So they show us a couple more examples of what is coming to Combat Evolved: new visors, new weapon skins, new vehicle skins. So everything is getting a fresh coat of paint, which is absolutely awesome. My personal favorite has got to be the Hot Rod Warthog skin. This thing just looks insane. But the best part is, if you're one of those people that just want a legacy classic Halo experience, you don't want to see these crazy bright Warthogs driving about the place, there is an option in the game to turn off user skins. So if you just want to play the original games, without seeing these crazy skins, you do have that option, which is very, very nice. But for someone like me who's all about adding new stuff to the game, to kind of give it a fresh look, to give something new to the game, I'm very, very excited for this, and I cannot wait to see what they do for the other games after Comet Evolve. They also give a little bit more information about how the tier system is going to work. People can now unlock season points in campaign, firefight, as well as PvP, obviously. So if you're mostly a campaign player, you'll now be able to unlock the season points by playing campaign, which is really, really nice. And as well as that, you can now unlock any tier at any point. So say your favorite item for that season is at tier 97. You don't have to wait until you get all the way to 97. You can just spend your tier point on that from the very, very start. So it lets you kind of custom select what you want to pick and what you want to unlock whenever you feel like, which is really, really nice. So I'm very, very happy with how the season points are going to work. But don't worry, if you're still on season one, you've not yet got all 100 items of season one unlocked, you can do that at any time. Those are not going to disappear and go away. You'll still be able to unlock them even when season two comes out. They also talk about the Halo 3 customization a bit, and let me just say, these elites look absolutely beautiful. They have never looked better, but being able to change the color of everything individually is really, really awesome. It's very, very exciting that we're going to be able to take our Halo 3 characters and just make them look exactly how we want. And on top of that, they also announced that they're restoring the functionality for emblems to appear on in-game armors in Halo 3. So basically, your custom emblem will now be on your armor in MCC, just like how it was way back in the OG Halo 3, which is really nice to see that return. It's a very subtle but really, really nice thing to have in the game. So moving on from that, they talk about Forge a little bit. I'm very, very excited to let you all know that Forge is releasing for Halo Reach, Halo 2 Anniversary, and Halo 3 all whenever Halo 3 releases on PC. So for all of you people that have been waiting for Halo Reach Forge, it is coming as soon as Halo 3 releases, which is very, very exciting. There's only one problem. There is currently no file share in the game, so any files you're gonna have to download and put into your documents yourself. But they have also announced that they are gonna be working on a file share for the game. So that's coming in the future. A working file share will come to MCC. Finally, I feel like it should have been there, but better late than never. So after that, they go on to talk about the challenges a little bit. The challenge hub is coming to the MCC. This is something that I am very, very excited about, simply because it means that I have something to work towards every day that I log into the MCC. I have challenges that I want to unlock for experience, as well as item rewards. So there are going to be actual items tied to challenges as well, which I think is really, really nice. So if there's like a weapon skin or a vehicle skin or a visor for Combat Evolved, I'll be able to unlock that through a challenge, which is going to be just perfect because it's going to give me even more reason to try and do that challenge. And now at the bottom of the update, they go on to talk about the state of the game. So basically any of the top community reported issues, which I'll put a screenshot of on the screen right now. So these are the biggest issues that they are currently investigating and trying to solve at this very moment in time. So of course there might be other issues, but these are the ones that they are making a priority. And after that, they talk about global features and development status. So this is stuff that they are either working on right now or in design iteration or in the backlog to be worked on later. So actively in development, we have progression system improvements, including challenges, UI/UX improvements around navigation, roster customization, and many more areas of the game, view model adjustments, Steam account linking, in-game FPS cap/adjustments, customization improvements, PC file share, additional video settings/options. So the PC file share and additional video settings/options are just added to actively in development, but I think a file share is going to be absolutely just monumental for the Master Chief Collection. Now in design iteration, we have custom game browser, input-based matchmaking, regional server selection, crossplay between Xbox and PC, which is going to be huge, additional mod support, text chat improvements, better ways to report players, and double key binds for all games. So in the backlog, pending further discussions, which is basically stuff they are wanting to work on, but it's not a top priority at this very moment. They have VFR improvements to Reach and H2A, so this is variable frame rate. So basically having an uncapped frame rate, they want to make it a better experience on Reach and Halo 2 Anniversary. Idle system improvements, bringing PC features to console like FOV sliders. This is a big comment that I get on a lot of my videos. The FOV slider is indeed coming to Xbox. Additional accessibility support, split screen on PC, and HDR support on PC. So I'm very, very excited to see all of this stuff added to the MCC. I always felt like the Master Chief Collection could be like the greatest game of all time, as long as it's all put together correctly. So I feel like it's finally getting there. Yes, might be a long time after its initial release, but the PC version is coming together very nicely. There's little issues here and there, but overall, I'm a very, very happy Halo player. So I hope that Halo 3 releases on PC in the very near future. I have no idea what I'm going to do now that I don't have Halo 3 on PC, but I'll make my way. I will find my way. It is now July. Halo Infinite gets revealed this month. I hope Halo 3 comes out the next couple of weeks. So all in all, it's a very exciting time to be a Halo fan. But if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you drop a like down below and subscribe if you're brand new. I love keeping you all updated with anything and everything Halo. So it's going to be a very exciting time here going into the summer. So I cannot wait to hear more and see what's next for all of us. But once again, thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next one.
Bye.